The next one is springs in series. When two springs are connected in series, what will be its effective time period? This is the structure of the series spring tech. This is one spring. To the another spring, they are connected another one. Maybe these two are oscillating under the load. When two springs are connected in series, therefore, their force constant 1 by k is equal to 1 by k1 plus 1 by k2. Therefore, it is 1 by k is equal to k1, k2, where it is k1 plus k2. Therefore, k is equal to k1, k2 by k1 plus k2. This is the effective force constant when two or more springs are connected in series. Therefore, time period T is equal to 2 pi root capital M by K. Therefore, time period in series is equal to 2 pi into root of M by, where K is equal to K1, K2 by K1 plus K2. So, therefore, it is K1 plus K2 by K1, K2. This is the effective time period in the series combination of the springs. Therefore, the frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi into square root of K1, K2 by M into K1 plus K2. So, we can write this one as Fs. The next case is the springs are in parallel. So what we can understand, when two springs are parallel to each other, this is one spring, this is another spring. So, what we can understand, this is the load which is common to two springs. Its spring constant is K2, its spring constant is K1. Therefore, K parallel is equal to K1 plus K2. From this, we can write T1 is equal to 2 pi square root of M by K1. T2 is equal to 2 pi square root of M divided by K2. So, where K1 is equal to C by T1 square, let us suppose, because if you do the calculation from this, T1 square is equal to 4 pi square into M by K1. From this, K1 is equal to 4 pi square into M by T1 square. This 4 pi square m, we can say that C, where C is equal to 4 pi square m, such like K2 is equal to C by T2 square. Therefore, K is equal to K1 plus K2. Therefore, C by T square is equal to C by T1 square plus C by T2 square. Therefore, 1 by T square is equal to 1 by T1 square plus 1 by T2 square. Therefore, T1 square, T2 square as LCM. Then the up one is T2 square plus T1 square is equal to 1 by T square. Therefore, T square is equal to T1 square, T2 square by T1 square plus T2 square. Therefore, T is equal to square root of T1, T2 by T1 square T2 square by T1 square plus T2 square. Therefore, T is equal to T1 T2 by square root of T1 square plus T2 square. This is the time period or effective time period when two springs are connected in parallel. This is the problem which is related to the time period of the springs or loaded spring system. A mass of 2 kg attached to a spring of force constant 260 Newton per meter makes 100 oscillations. What is the time taken? This is the picture for the given concept. This is some 2 kg. This is the spring. This is the 2 kg mass which is fixed to the spring. Its force constant is 260 Newton per meter. So, we should find out the time period first. Then only we can able to find the time taken for 100 oscillations. Therefore, time period is equal to 2 pi into square root of m by k. Therefore, it is 2 into 3.14 into square root of, so what is m? 2 kg. What is k? 260. Therefore, it is 2 into 3.14 into square root of 1 by 130. If you do the whole calculation, we will get 0.5509 seconds is equal to time period. Time period means time taken for one complete oscillation. Here we should find out the time taken for 100 complete oscillations. Therefore, total time taken for 100 oscillations. Therefore, T is equal to 100 into 0.5509 seconds. T is equal to 55.09 seconds. So, this much time will be taken by the spring to oscillate for 100 times. The next concept is damped harmonic oscillation. So, what is the meaning of this damped harmonic oscillation? Let us suppose this is a simple pendulum. When it is placed like this, if external force is applied, it can able to do the oscillations with some amplitude on either ends. We can say that if we neglect the air resistance and other factors which are applied on the pendulum, we can say that this pendulum can do the same amplitude on either ends because we are neglecting the remaining factors which objects the amplitude to be same. If this pendulum structure was placed in a high viscous liquid like honey, oil, grease, can it do the same amount of oscillations and can it possess the same amplitude or not? The answer is impossible, because if you see the surroundings when this is executing the simple harmonic oscillations, the air is the medium around it. Air's density is less, air won't resist that much until and unless it has some large amount of force, but we are neglecting in the natural cases, and air won't object because of its density. Air is a free medium which can move the object very freely. The same structure I placed in an oil like this. Or take a vessel which is in a big dimension. Let us suppose this is oil, oil, grease, honey, whatever it is. Suppose I applied some force to move this pendulum and I have applied the force up to this end. And I applied the force, just I released. The actual case is this oscillator should do some same amplitude in the another end also. But according to the given observation, it doesn't exist the same amount of the amplitude on the either end. Its amplitude is decreased, maybe up to here. So we are expecting the same amplitude in the second end. No, limited to here, next here, next to here, next to here, next to here, like this. It is coming to rest very easily for in a small interval of time. What happened really in this motion? This body's amplitude is continuously decreasing. Suppose if it is doing the simple harmonic oscillation, but its amplitude is continuously decreasing. For this, the graph will be like this. It is a time dependent like this. Do the oscillation, same amplitude on either ends, continuously. But here the amplitude is not same. It will be like this. See, what we can expect is amplitude is continuously decreasing. We can see the difference in the heights of each peak. So what we can understand is here the amplitude is remains constant, here amplitude is decreasing. If a simple harmonic oscillation with the decreasing amplitude continuously is called damped harmonic oscillation. A simple harmonic oscillation with the decreasing amplitude continuously is called damped harmonic oscillation. Now we will discuss what are the factors which are affecting the damped harmonic oscillation. So if a body is executing the damped harmonic oscillations like this, which was placed in a liquid, we know that if the body is executing the oscillations on that, force is equal to Kx is always acting, where this force Kx is equal to resistive force or restoring force. Another force is also acting on this continuously along with the restoring. That force is viscous force. Why? This liquid, maybe it is oil, grease, honey, etc., etc. These materials, these liquid materials has viscosity. So they won't allow the objects to move freely through them. That's why the force which is acting on the pendulum because of the surrounding medium such like oil, grease, honey is viscous force, BV. viscous force. Where B is the constant or a positive constant which explains the nature of the medium. Nature of the medium means maybe it is elastic medium or viscous medium. If you want to find out, this will be explained by B. Therefore, the general equation F is equal to minus kx minus bv. We can write F is equal to ma, therefore it is minus kx minus bv. Where m into what is a? D square x by dt square is equal to minus kx minus b into. We can write v also in form of x like this, dx by dt. Therefore, d square x by dt square is equal to minus k by m x into minus b by m into dx by dt. So we can write d square x by dt square is equal to minus k by m is nothing but minus omega square into x minus b by m into dx by dt. You can write this LHS and RHS in a form of an equation. Therefore, it is d square x by dt square plus b by m into dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to 0. This is also a second order differential equation, which is the differential form of damped harmonic oscillation. Suppose we got this equation like this. D square x by dt square plus b by m into dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to 0. If you want to find out the solution of the x, so we should take x is equal to some constant. The constant is x is equal to a into e power minus bt by 2m into cos omega dash t plus phi. So dx by dt we will get one value, d square x by dt square also we will get one value. If we substitute these values and we will get a solution. So after substituting these x values, we will get the solution for omega also. Therefore, omega will become square root of k by m minus b square by 2m square. The energy of the damped harmonic oscillator DHO is equal to half kx square, where x is equal to this much. So if along the mean position it is x, along the vertical position it is y, so therefore the total energy will become half k a square e power minus bt by m. This is the total energy of the damped harmonic oscillator. This damped harmonic oscillator has many cases of the resonance and forced oscillations. We will see those forced oscillation cases in this DHO. The next one is forced oscillations. These oscillations are not natural to the object. These are forcefully implemented by another object. That means there are two terms to understand this concept. What are those two terms? First one is natural frequency. What is the meaning of natural frequency? Tendency to oscillate for long times in a short interval of time means the number will be more for the executing of oscillations. So what is the meaning of natural frequencies? Let us suppose if this is the oscillator, a force is applied on this oscillator, then because of the applied force, for the next time interval up to some time extent, this body will execute some oscillations around the mean position. This is its natural frequency of the body or material what is used in the oscillation. That what is the meaning of forced oscillation? This is said to be natural oscillation due to the natural frequency. Forced oscillation means this oscillating body, if suppose it influenced any other object which is nearby, then the second object also do the oscillations with respect to this one, sometimes equal in number. This type of oscillations are called forced oscillations. These forced oscillations tends to a physical phenomenon called resonance. The equation to find the natural frequency, forced frequency and resonance, it is depend upon the equation of damped harmonic oscillator. What is the damped harmonic oscillator's equation? D square x by dt square plus b by m into dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to 0. But in place of 0, we should not write 0 because some forced oscillations are executing. That means the total result can execute a result. That's why we can write m into d square x by dt square plus b into dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to f d cos omega dt. This is the equation for the natural frequency of a damped harmonic oscillator, where cos omega means oscillations are doing in the linear range. That's why in problems we are discussing it is the linear simple harmonic oscillator. If it is vertical, we can state this one as a sine function. Because it is linear, we are stating this one as a cos function. Therefore, the equation which results the force of the damped harmonic oscillator, it will be like this. Whenever a body is oscillating with some frequency, it has some amplitude. So the equation m into d square x by dt square plus b into dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to fd cos omega dt, where omega d is nothing but driven frequency. Means the frequency which is supplied to the other object from the naturally oscillating body. So this is driven frequency. When the oscillation takes place, it has some amplitude. So the amplitude is A is equal to F by M square into omega square minus omega d square plus omega d square b square whole power half. Whole power half means it is under the square root, where omega is natural frequency. Where omega d is driven frequency. Driven. So what we can understand from this? There are two cases. Small damping, critical damping and greater damping. Suppose first case, small damping. So in small damping, the driven frequency is far from the natural frequency. So far from the natural frequency. So if you see the equation, this one, the driven frequency is this one. This is very far from omega square minus omega d square. That's why omega dB is much less than m square into omega square minus omega d square. That's why we can neglect this term in the equation. That's why amplitude is equal to f by m square into omega square minus omega d square whole power half. This is the amplitude of the small damping cases. What is the graph for the small damping cases? So if we drew the graph between omega d by omega to x at different amplitudes and different frequencies, it will be like this. So this is omega d by omega, this is x, therefore amplitude increases. Like this we can say, at different frequencies, different displacements, this will be the form of the graphs. Next one. The driving frequency is close to the natural frequency. That means omega is equal to omega d. So the general amplitude equation is A is equal to f by m square into omega square minus omega d square plus omega d square b square whole power half. Natural frequency is equal to driving frequency or driven frequency. That means this term will become 0 because omega square minus omega d square. Therefore, amplitude is equal to f by omega dB. If the natural frequency or the driven frequency of the body is close to the natural frequency, it creates a lot of amplitude or the largest amplitude. This is called resonance. Resonance means matching of two frequencies, maybe from the two different sources. So the phenomenon of increasing amplitude when the driven frequency of oscillator is equal to its natural frequency are close to, or when the driven frequency of oscillator is close to natural frequency, is called resonance. Physically, this resonance has many uses. Suppose TV channel sends a signal with a frequency, we are setting the same frequency with the remote. If these two frequencies are matched, then the resonance takes place, then the clarity and sound will be in the great amplitude. To tune a radio channel, yes, we are simply using the same resonance technique. If you want to find the velocity of sound in air, we know that air column resonance example, well, the water is leaked from the bottom and the top air column will be formed, and this air column's length will be vibrated when the tuning fork is placed on it. These are all the examples of the resonance. This resonance has many uses. Next one is critical damping. Yes, we know that amplitude is equal to F by M square into omega square minus omega d square plus omega d square b square whole power half. Critical damping means if omega is less than omega d, that means this whole case will be negative, because omega square minus omega d square will always be a negative. So in the negative cases are simply ideal, may not be possible. Only in the critical damping, these are all possible. This critical damping, mechanically, it is equivalent to LCR circuit. LCR circuit is one of the example of damped harmonic oscillator mechanically. So like this, we can see the damping, different damping cases in the harmonic oscillators. The next one is free oscillations and forced oscillations. To demonstrate this, let us take a rubber string, try to hang four pendulum of different sizes. A, B, C, D. First of all, this is the rubber string. These four are four pendulums. First, I have applied some force on the pendulum D, means it will oscillate. The oscillations of the pendulum D passing to the all other pendulum which are connected to the same rubber string. But if you see the dimensions of this pendulum, D and B are in the same length. That's why D is applying the, it is doing some free oscillations, but this D is passing the forced oscillations through the connections. B will achieve the oscillations first because of the same length. After some time, this B and D will oscillate with the same frequency. So, oscillates with same frequency. Previously, A and C are too much differ in the length. There is a large variation in the difference in the length. So, it will take more time to oscillate with the frequency of B and D for A and C. Anyway, after some time interval, these four will oscillate with the same frequency. We have applied the force at D. Because of the applied force, this D is doing oscillations. Those oscillations are called free oscillations. If with the help of length, B is doing the same amount of oscillations with D while it is connected, that's why we can say that B is in resonance with D. A and D are not at all in the same dimensions, but they are also doing the oscillations with the same number after some time. That's why A and C and B are doing forced oscillations. If a tuning fork is placed on a wooden box, another tuning fork is placed at some distance on the same wooden flask, wooden box. After some time, the second one will vibrate with the first one's frequency. First one is vibrating with the natural frequency. Second one is vibrating with the frequency of the first one. So like this. Maybe lengths are different, dimensions are different, and frequency of the different. This is going to lose its natural frequency property and it is vibrating with the frequency of the first one. So we can say the first one is free vibration, second one is forced vibrations. So same length constitute the same frequency, because frequency is inversely proportional to the length. So n is equal to 1 by 2l into root of t by m. So like that, we can say the one of the values or one of the different vibrations in this lesson. So like this, we have started with types of oscillations, SHM, finished the DHM, the graphs related and the energy graphs related to the all energy, all oscillations, and finally we are concluded with this resonance and forced oscillations. So for this concept, we are concluding this lesson.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.